dance or something, like waiting for the guy to shoot. It's like it just happened, right? I would like to just have him shoot, anticipate a shot, spin behind him, score. And sometimes this, he beats my head in my hands, I come out of position, I make a mistake, he gets to my leg, okay, what am I gonna do from there? So we're gonna start with single leg, not my right leg. I can only do it on my right leg too. I don't have the tricks for my left, so don't tell anybody. But baseline defense. What I want to make sure I do is I want to lean on him always. Okay, so the second he shoots, he should never get this kind of clean look on me where his head's up into me and I'm not into him. Does that make sense? Because he's trying to get up to his feet. All right, on all of our leg attacks, our goal is to secure the leg, get to your feet, and finish. So once he gets to my leg, I got to anticipate it a little bit so that I'm leaning on him. All right, once I'm leaning on him, that way it's hard for him to get up to his feet. I make sure my hand stuffs his head and I anchor. This anchor is often neglected, all right? And it's the same for high crotch, too. Go on, high crotch. It's the same for high crotch. I lean, I stuff, and I anchor, all right? I'm pulling up on his chest, okay? When I pull up on his chest, I'll get heavier, I'll have more weight on him, I'll be able to straighten my leg. So those are kind of my pointers. I lean, I stuff, I anchor, and I straighten my leg. So I get to this position right here. Hook, all right? Now this is what I call baseline defense, right? If his lock pops, you know, I might just spin behind him, all right? Same with high crotch, you know, I kind of give him a little bit of hit. If his lock pops, I might just take my butt drag or go behind. But sometimes, in this position, this baseline single leg position, I get to here, I'll see his trail leg up, right? Because what's gonna happen, we're taught to do what? Run backside, okay? So when I see his trail leg, I gotta make sure I don't let him get something on me. Watch this side. If he gets his elbow down, okay. I'm in trouble because now I can't pivot. I can't pivot off my knee and face it. So I gotta make sure my knee's kind of up, all right? And he's gonna be running backside, and I gotta make sure I can face him. At some point, I see that trail leg close enough, I'm gonna jam him. So I use my inside knee here, and I jam. Instead of sliding off the position by straightening my leg, I'll jam him like this. See, I kind of crunch him a little bit. Now I'm gonna have a big step, and I'm gonna drag his head to his knee with my right knee. All right, because remember, his head on the inside of my leg. So I just step and then I drag. And now I'm kind of tee up. So now I see I was in this position right here. Now what my hands are doing, that's what my lower half is doing. It stuffs, it steps, my knee goes down and I drag right here and I pinch his head between my legs. What my arm's doing is my left elbow is punching the back of his knee. Not his crotch, the back of his knee. So that he can't straighten his leg. Okay? So turn a little bit. Right here. So jam, step, drag, chest lock first. Alright? You'll see he's in the cradle position here. His ear is on his shoulder, his knee is in his armpit, he's crinkled up, right? He's tight. I have a chest lock. Once I have him secured, I'll change my lock from here to an actual cradle, and I'll start to finish. Alright, which I'll talk about here in a second. So again, it stems from my baseline defense. It's not. And I'm not gonna lie, now I start doing it for my feet. I've been doing it for so long, where it's all in one motion. It's stuff, straighten, twist, out. All right? But the main thing is I'm taking him who's on a single leg like this, and I'm taking his head like this. All right? And crinkling him up so I have a good lock. So again, baseline defense, we get to this position. We stuff, we anchor, we straighten our leg. He'll be trying to run backside. Make sure we don't let him get the angle. So keep facing him. I jam him, step, drag his head through his knee, and get that chest lock with my elbow deep. Got him. All right, he can't move. His head's trapped under me, and it's in between my legs. Can't go cradle, and then we'll finish. All right, any questions on the mechanics there with the head inside single, drag, cradle? Any questions? All right. I kind of call that one like my head drag. It's kind of awkward, a little footwork here, where I go like this. Step, knee down, drag, right? So I kind of inched his head, which was stuck right here, and brought it to my left knee, okay? The other way I get to this position a lot, same thing, single leg. Sometimes I have a fall on my hip, so I kind of slide. I call this one the head slide. So the head. This time I drag the head. This time I reach, I might kind of dive over and reach to get that deck of my elbow in the back of his knee. and I kind of slide like a baseball slide, and you'll see how I end up on my hip like this. Alright? So I kind of brought his head, and I kind of trapped it. It was kind of a little higher, maybe he had better head position, he was up into me. So I couldn't really drag it, right? I couldn't drag his head, it's not down by my knee, his head's up a little bit. So okay, I use my stomach, and I pull it like this, and slap. Now, right here, my hands are locked, I have good depth with my elbow, hands locked. I can't just lean this way though without undoing my hands, or my hand will be trapped. So, as I pull him to his hip, I undo my hands like this. He's still trapped, right? I'm still using my stomach and my elbow depth to keep his head trapped. All I'm gonna do is hit my stuff, and then let his head pop back up quick. All right? So, again, this one's more, his head's a little higher. It's not down low by my knee. If it's down here, yeah, I just drag it with my knee. If it's up a little higher, I kind of dive over, get my elbow deep, and I slide like this. Then once I have him crinkled up, I post, I hip heist, and I crank. All right, so again, he's in a single baseline defense. Oh, his head's up, he did a good job. All right, I'm gonna slide, got my depth. Post, come on top, crank. All right, you'll see Demas. This is kind of the way his ends up looking every time. All right, he does it on the left side. So I have head stuff, baseline defense, drag, and then I have when his head's up a little higher, how I slide, okay? So those are two ones I do off baseline single leg defense. Any questions on that one? Sure? Todd, no? You good? Okay. All right. Off low level, I'll do another one off the low single. So he's at low level, boom. Okay, Randy made a mistake. What was Randy's mistake right here? It's a pop quiz, anybody? There you go, his head placement is bad, right? Put his head, I call this the nutcracker. Put his head below the back of my knee, right? This is a hard position for Randy to finish. We get caught up in this, go over the top. It's like a 45 second finish, if he even gets there, all right? I know we're not doing low level, but this is just bonus. Make sure low level guy, he's got head placement on my knee like this. Lower his butt for me already. Alright? So, if you guys get a 4.0 student, that shoots his low level in the nutcracker. Alright? If he does that, good. I step and I sit and I go straight leg on the back of his head right away. If he's solid, he's got head, I might just grab his shoulders a little bit and give him a little knee just to get him into that nutcracker. So I kind of finesse him in there so his head's past my knee. Once there, again, so my lower half, this is just my bottom half is doing, step, and I pivot, and I drop straight leg on the back of his head. So there's no space here. Notice how my toe is curled under as well. I'm not sitting on my butt with no height, all right? So I can be kind of strong here. I have some other options. So my toe's curled under. So that's kind of what my lower half's doing. And I anticipate a shot second he goes underneath me, I might go, step. Here. At the same time, what my arms are doing, I'm dropping my chest on them, so it's tight, and I'm going, again, anchor tight waist, where do you think the left elbow is going? Common theme of all my cradles, right? The left arm is in the back of his knee, right? Not locking the crotch, what happens here? Flat, or he goes up back, right? When I go right here, the back of his knee, he can't go flat, all right? So, elbow, depth, back of the knee. So right here, this is the first part. He shoots low level, step, pivot, drop into this chest lock. Once I stop him, right, and then I have to have weight forward on his head too. Because this is the progression. He shoots low level, I sit on his head, he goes out the back, you know, he's good. That's what he's gonna be doing. So I gotta make sure I'm kind of driving my lock towards his head so he can't get his head up. Alright? And I'm just, my leg is flexed and straight. All right, it's heavy, so I got him like this. All right, once I stop the momentum and I feel like I'm safe, all right, I might change off right here, like a high touch. And I lift it up, and my back arm goes deep. All right, now I just gotta open up my leg a little bit because it's so tight on the back of his neck to get my hands in for the cradle. And then I just drive my knee over my toe and straighten my leg. All right, so again, I'm just getting you guys to the cradle, to the guys on the hip. I'll talk about my finish here in a second. So, he shoots low level. Boom. I step, I pivot, I drop, and chest lock.
secured it, got weight on his head, he's not coming out the back door, change off, switch, high crotch, lift it up, back arm punches, and then cradle, drop.
All right?
Any questions on that one? All right, that's my low level, low single cradle.
All right, I'll talk about finishing now, and then I'm going to kind of show you a little sequence that Portland's all ties together. So the way I finish, what drives me absolutely nuts is when I see guys trying to finish from their own back. You see this, right? Whatever move it is, whether it's low level, right here, we always see kids trying to finish it like this.
Down, and they're on their own back, right? Trying to pin the guy. And my shoulder's a little underrated. It's just, I don't see how I'm going to get some pin.
There's a time to do it. Obviously, if there's 6 seconds left in the period, you need to get those backs, and you need just some swipes. Get it going. All right? But I'm not going to get the fall in that position, laying on my own back. I might get a girlfriend, it looks cool. I'm not going to get a fall. All right? So, what we need to do is make sure our chest is on the guy. So, however, I got my position right here. Got him. Up, cradle, put him on his hip. Watch how I kind of pull him underneath me. Alright? So he kind of rotates underneath me. I suck him up with my arms right here, and I take him from his hip to like his butt, or his tailbone, and I lift him. At the same time, I use my left forearm, it's kind of like this little wave motion here, to let his knee pop through. So like right now, his knee is in my stomach, alright, or my chest. As I lift him with my arms, I pull the rug out from under him like this. You'll see how I kind of use my left arm to finesse his knee from my stomach to like my neck. That's so it gets to like this position, all right? And then I'll settle in, you'll see how I'm chest to chest, and I'm burying him, and he's getting choked big time with my right arm. So I get to this position, I lift, I kind of pop my hips, lift, and I see how I let the knee slide through, it's now up here, went from low, I look at it right here. Now it's in my neck. And then I settle in. I'll step in between, but I don't hook. All right? So I'll step in the middle like this. I use my forehead and my 2 feet as a post. All right? My tripod's like this.
Got him. Right here. I'm wide. All right? I have good balance. I can't go anywhere. He's getting choked. All
right? I'm looking right at his back. So I know what adjustments I got to make. All right? Oh, I got to rock forward. No. Lean back. All right? She get the fall from here. So we kind of posture up. So again, how we got there, low level, doesn't matter. Got him, cradle, drive, big tight lift. All right, I'm not gonna be able to just drag him over. He's gonna look flat, he's gonna be on his stomach. I gotta lift him, let the knee pop through. Got him, settle in, right here, step in the middle of the corner. Got it. All right, any questions for that? If you're having a real hard time finishing, there's times where I will kind of fall on my back and hip, but I only stay there momentarily. I might put him on his back, watch the hip pipes, how I come back on top.
So if I can't go like this. So get him over the criteria. But once I'm here, I pop, I come back on top.
All right, I got it tight. All right, so that kind of ability to hip pipes like that, whether it's on a bridge, I talked about it earlier with hip heist for your position is in, but you've heard me say hip heist 3 or 4 times now, right? Hip heisting, I think, is crucial in terms of not just this cradle position, but just wrestling in general. Stand up, cut away, floating out of a high crotch. I've got a high crotch on me. How do I get out of my high crotch? Hip heist. So I can't stress enough how much of a believer I am in just the high hip heist drill. Somebody blows the whistle. Hip ice. Sometimes even faster than that. But it just correlates to wrestling so much. Alright? Good hips. It helps you recover and everything. So if you feel like you can't just straight up lift them, kind of bully them over with this big lift, you can't get that. Alright? And you have to go lean towards his head a little bit to get to his back, that's fine. But don't stay here. I can't even fall here. But my second line. Feet close to my butt, hip place. Sorry, you guys hear me? People, Mike,
All right. Here, grab this off. Sorry about that.
I'm sure.
So anyway, hip heisting in that position, I think, is crucial.
Got it.
So anyway, you guys can hear me?
Yeah. All right.
So hip heisting there, finishing like that, it's cool. The only time I'll ever get real crazy is if the guy sits through his inside cheek. Has that ever happened? All right, so I get the cradle.
As soon as I get it, he sits through his inside cheek like this. Oh no.
Right? You know the kamikaze one, right? Where we kind of roll all the way across. Like that, come up top. That's all right. I like doing, I do like more of a cartwheel. I don't like rolling across my own back if I have to.
So one thing I'll do is I'll yoke him back with my arms, I'll post my head, and watch how I cartwheel over top and I end up in the same position as if I just threw him to his opposite hip. So I whip him back, post, cartwheel, and now I just do my lift.
Right? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of the three ways I'll finish those three cradles. So any questions on those? Pretty, I won't say straightforward, but to get the gist of it, right? All right, I'm okay. Yeah, we're good. So, some cool other techniques that happen from these positions here. He shoots a single leg, low level, all right? I go to drop my straight leg on the back of his head. I go to get my chest lock. Maybe I didn't weight my leg or his head properly. I get to this position and he shoots his knee under. You see this a lot, right? Mm-hmm. Guy's going to this cheek and then he's probably gonna go to this cheek. He's gonna try to finish the single leg, all right? So on his way through, the second he hits his cheek, you'll see, one thing I do, here's where I think guys get trouble a little bit. They hang on in the chest lock, or the lock in the crotch, right? So Randy sits, and they hang on to this like this, and they end up upside down, you know? They're trying to wrestle with Randy hooks. They're in trouble.
All right, watch the hamstrings though, buddy.
You need those, all right? So you gotta be careful hanging on like that. You know, you think like, well, I'm just gonna hold this out. This is you too. Thinking you're just gonna hold on for dear life and bang for a stalemate, right? I let go of my hands. I don't have many moves when I'm upside down. So when he hits his butt, I let go of my hands, I post, and all I'm gonna do is see how my knee and my toe are facing up, facing the ceiling, I turn it down, and then I just highlight. I pull my heel to my butt to break free. All right? How side is pretty good. He understands this. I'm a freestyler. He shoots low. I want the chest lock and I want the cradle, but you know what? He went underneath. I didn't get, okay, undo your hands. Don't hang that upside down. Undo your hands, grab his lat, turn your knee down, high leg, kick away. I'm talking about like viciously. Like, the guy can't hang on, right? Hurts his shoulder. He can't hang on like that. So that's kind of one of the things I do from this series. He shoots low, boom. I get his, hit the leather, pull through. Back to safety. I'm not getting scored on. I'm not upside down, all right? Another thing that happens, this is like, I everything I do is kind of like progression based, right? Because this, I do it. It's not predetermined. This is just from years of flowing and, you know, David Colton sparring, whatever it may be, get creative with your wrestling, right? So I do believe in that. So he shoots low level. He knows that if I get my elbow deep in the back of his knee, he's in trouble. So the second he feels me trying to sit around, he goes flat right here to this position. You got some guys that are pretty good, Askren is pretty good at it. We can still bend low enough to get the guy at the knee and still crinkle him up and cradle him, right? But an awesome guy, he's gonna have this hip there. I can't get to his knee, right? That's fine, I'm gonna go over top. So I go from straight leg to bent leg, and then I dive over this way, my hand just weaves right under his shoelaces like this, and I kick him right in the armpit, and then I chest him, step up, trying to get turned. Whatnot. Alright, so again, he shoots low, boom. I go to get chest lock, he goes flat. Alright, I go from straight leg to bent leg, over top, kick. Got it. Alright, so see how this series is kind of tying together? I got a hold, I got everything that he can combat, my straight leg on the low level, I have an answer for. I want the cradle, right, because that ends the match. But if he goes flat, I'll dive over top. He tries to come out the back, okay, I'll get free, I'll high lift. So whatever he does, I kind of have an answer. So knowing the progression for the defensive guy is good, but also for the offensive guys, he kind of knows. He knows once he goes, you know, to his inside cheek, that he better change hands, right? He goes like this, he goes outside the back. You better grab it to this right hand, hand transfer it, or if he tries to hold it with his left, it's gone. So you better
check it,
turn quicker, and then you're in a basic single leg finish. Any questions on that? Single leg. All right. Another way we get here, he shoots a single leg backside. Uh-oh. We got a great shot. Man, that was awesome. All right. From here, you know, I kind of pull him down, sit on him a little bit. I always have weight on him, so I don't want him to get it easy up to his feet. That's the last thing I want him to do is just, hey, no pressure, go ahead, check. Yep, you're good. That was cute. Right? Make it hard on this guy, so I'm sitting on him. All right? Now, I can try to face him the whole time, try to face him, maybe get that position. He's going to be running backside. So I kind of bait him a little bit. I bait him, I'm sitting on him the whole time, and then I go this way, around the back, and I drop him in my straight leg, chest. And now the series is the same as if you just shot it straight up, right? Low level. So if he shoots backside single leg, can you guys hear me or do you think I'm good? Good? Okay. Okay. So he shoots backside. We just go so hard in the technique session, man. We just threw him a mic. All right. He gets backside single leg and he's low. Sit on him. All right. Here's where I can't do it though. You have guys try to do it when their knee and their shin are on the mat. Ah. All right. Right here. They try to go all the way around and this is what happens. They go around and the ring goes out. So they did it the wrong time. Your knee and your shin were down. So if we're in this position, this is common wrestling, this position, right? Before I go to around the backside, I better get my knee up and drive back into it. Now I can do it. Now I can do it. Right? Or he shoots backside single leg. I'm leaning on him, my knee's up. I go around the backside. I go to drop, he goes flat. Okay, fine, I go over top. Got it. Okay? Remember, whatever shot he shoots, maybe he shot a high crotch. I can turn it into this whole series. Just by this. Oh, now he's on a single leg, right? Just rerouted his head, that's all. Now I can stuff, anchor, get into my cradle, my original cradle I showed you. Trail it back. Right here, got him. Or even, he shot high crotch. Oh, I rerouted his head, it's a single leg. Turned away, stuffed it down, got his lock below my knee, went this way, got him. All right, so I kind of can get into this little series for any shot he shoots. Cool? All right, how we doing on time? Anybody have a, 10:25, okay. So, that's kind of my leg attack defense series. All right, I know I didn't harp on the baseline stuff as much, but we all got that, right? So those are kind of the tricks from my cradle series with the head drag, the head slide, and then the low level. And then a little bit add on with the low level defense. So, and then how to finish the cradle, which is really important. Nothing gets me more mad than when I see a guy have a guy dead in the cradle and he just can't finish, right? I guess I should harp a little bit about my lock. I kind of go like this, gut wrenching, and I make sure that the guy's tight, my elbows are close, right? To me, this is okay. I have my hands out, lift your head up. If he can move his head around, if he has play in his head, I don't really have him. I have him like down, right? Kind of, you see how he's my like thigh a little bit? I have him tight. All right, he can't move his head now. This is when I'm gonna get the fall. Back over. This is a takedown now. I'm gonna come out front. I ain't gonna get the fall. I don't have any depth right here. My elbow, my wrist, I got wrist deep. I need to get elbow deep so I can kind of pinch it. All right. So if there's any questions now, I guess now would be a time I can answer them. It doesn't even have to be about cradle, to be honest. It doesn't have to be about technique. It could be about whatever. Anything Ohio State wrestling or any questions you guys have, I'll be glad to answer it now. And then if not, I think I turn it over to Lou, right? Is that the schedule? Lou on there? He's terrible, man. I'm just going to the bathroom probably. What's up? good question. No, I would say I don't. I use this to chest lock to get him into the position, right? So I have my tight waist already here. I go like this. The second I feel like, hey, listen, I can undo my hands if he's not gonna move, that's what I'll do. But I definitely don't want to have this. His head might, you know, I don't really have it, and then just let go and miss my lock. So I guess it's when I feel as if I have a second without him moving. You know, remember, my elbow's deep in the back of his knee. That's what's making sure his knee can't move. And my legs pinching his head. All right? Right here. So he's not going anywhere. He's not going anywhere. I have a second. But also what helps, though, is this depth. That depth of my left arm, so that when I undo my hand, this right hand only has to travel, you know, a little distance. If I'm wrist deep, now it's okay, I gotta get my right arm, because my right arm has to go further underneath it, right? When I'm deep this way, it's up by his face. I undo my hand, it takes 1 second. It's quick. So the depth of my left arm is crucial. Good question. Tony, question. That's where I learned it. All right. Well, I appreciate you guys. Thanks for coming again, and hope you guys enjoyed Wrestle Offs and Coach's Clinic.